Dear students, Namaste and welcome back to a new mathematics session. In the previous session, we have discussed first 11 questions from the miscellaneous exercise of chapter 13, probability. Hope it was clear for you all. In today's session, we shall discuss the remaining problems from the miscellaneous exercise. Let's move on to the topic. Next, we shall discuss question number 12. The question is, suppose we have four boxes A, B, C and D containing colored marbles as given below. One of the boxes has been selected at random and a single marble is drawn from it. If the marble is red, what is the probability that it was drawn from box A, box B and box C? There is a table is given to us mentioning the box labels and number of red, white and black balls. Here you are selecting a marble from the box, and if the marble is red, what is the probability that it was drawn from box A? That is the first question. What is the probability that it is from box B? That is the second question. And if the marble is red, what is the probability that it must be from box C? That is the third question. Here surely it is a reverse probability question. That means for solving reverse probability we must use Bayes' theorem, but here we will go with a different approach. Let R be the event of drawing a red marble that we have assumed, and EA, EB and EC respectively denote the events selecting box A, box B, box C. So event of choosing box A is EA, choosing box B is EB, choosing box C is EC. Now total number of marbles altogether in the box, there are 40 marbles are there, that you have to add all these marbles. So 1 plus 6 plus 3, from here itself 10 is there, and here 6 plus 4 10, again here 8 plus 2 10, here 6 plus 4 10, so total 4 rows. So we have 40 marbles total. Number of red marbles we have, when you take 6 plus 1 7, 7 plus 8 is 15. Number of red marbles 15, because we are asked to choose the red marbles. So number of red marbles we have written. Then probability of R, probability of choosing a red ball we have to calculate, that is 15 divided by 14. That is, when you cancel 5, it becomes 3 by 8. Next, probability of drawing a red ball from box A is given by, that is what the first question, probability of choose, what is the, you are choosing a red ball, what is the probability that it was from box A? So probability of choosing a red ball from box A is P of EA given R. EA given R in the sense you are selecting a ball from EA, means from box A, given that it is a red ball. By using the conditional probability, we can write the formula as P of EA intersection R divided by P of R. Conditional probability formula we are using. P of A given B is P of A intersection B divided by P of B. That formula we are using. P of EA intersection R divided by P of R. Now P of EA intersection R, in the sense, just define it this one first, then use the table to write the probability. P of EA intersection R, that means box A and a red marble. So box A and a red marble common. Box A and a red marble, in the sense you have one red marble from box A, total we have 40 marbles. That is 1 divided by 40. EA intersection R in the sense box A and a red marble, these two coming together, that means 1 red marble in box A, total number of marbles 40, that is 1 by 40 we can write. Then P of R we have calculated 3 by 8, that is 1 divided by 15. When you calculate, that is 1 by 40 into 8 by 3. So when you cancel 8 and 40, you will get 5 times, so 5 into 3, 15 denominator. So 1 by 15 is the answer. Next one, probability that the red marble is from box B is P of EB given R. P of EB given R means probability of choosing a red marble from box B, given that it is a red ball, and we have to find out the probability of choosing that red ball from box B. By using the formula, we can write P of EB intersection R divided by P of R. So EB intersection R, probability of choosing box B and a red ball together, box B and a red ball is 6. So here 6 divided by total number of balls, 40. So 6 divided by 40, then P of R we have calculated 3 by 8. That is equal to here 2 by 40 into 8 by 3. When you cancel, you will get 2 by 5 as the answer. Next is probability that the red marble is from box C, that is P of EC given R. Choosing a red ball from EC means box C. As before, we can use the formula P of EC intersection R divided by P of R. EC in the sense box C and a red ball. Box C and a red ball in the sense 8. Total number of balls 40. So 8 by 40 divided by P of R is same 3 by 8. That is equal to cancel it. You will get 8 by 15 as the answer. So these are the three questions asked, box A, box B and box C. So these three questions we have calculated. Next, we shall discuss question number 13. Assume that the chances of the patient having a heart attack are 40%. It is also assumed that a meditation and yoga course reduce the risk of heart attack by 30% and a prescription of certain drug reduces its chance by 25%. At a time, a patient can choose any one of the two options with equal probabilities. It is given that after going through one of the two options, the patient selected at random suffers a heart attack. Find the probability that the patient followed a course of meditation and yoga. This is what the question. Let's go through the question once again. Assume that the chances of patient having a heart attack 40%. The chances are 40%. Assume that a meditation and a yoga course reduce the risk of heart attack by 30%. Means if you do meditation and yoga, it reduces the risk by 30%. Means 70% chances are there. Certain drug reduces its chance by 25%. If you use some kind of drugs, means medicines, it reduces the chance by 25%. Means you will have 75% chance. Here, reduces the chance by 25%. In the sense, you will have balance 75% risk is there. At a time, a patient can choose any one of the two options with equal probabilities. Means, out of these two, means meditation and yoga and medicine. Out of these two, anyone can choose with equal probabilities. Means the probability there is 1 by 2. Out of 2, 1 you can choose. And it is given that after going through one of the two options, the patient selected at random suffers a heart attack. Even after doing meditation and yoga or some kind of medicines, even after using, you select a person, he is suffering from heart attack. You have to find out the probability that the patient followed a course of meditation and yoga. Means the person suffering from heart attack is doing meditation and yoga. That probability we have to calculate. Find the probability that the patient followed a course of meditation and yoga. Let's assume A, person suffering from heart attack, then E1 and E2. E1 means selected person doing yoga and meditation, and E2 selected person using drugs, means medicines. Then P of A is given to us 0.40, means 40%. Assume that the chances of patient having a heart attack, that is 40%. P of A we have already defined, person has a heart attack, chances is 40%, so 40 by 100, 0.40. Then P of E1 and E2, means here it is mentioned at a time a patient can choose any one of the two options with equal probabilities. Means P of E1 and P of E2 both are equal, the probabilities, that is 1 by 2. 1 you can choose out of 2. Next is P of A given E1. This is what somewhat very important, and you have to go through the question in a clear manner. Then only will be able to answer this question correctly. So P of A given E1 in the sense A is a person has a heart attack given that he is doing E1 in the sense following the course of yoga and meditation. Person is suffering from heart attack given that he is doing yoga and meditation. Means this one, in one different way we have to think. That means here 40% is a person's chance. A normal person who is having a heart attack is 40%, that is 0.40. And if you do meditation and yoga, it will reduce the risk by 30%. Means if you do meditation and yoga, you will get 70% chance of getting heart attack. And it is given to us here, it is reducing the risk by 30%. Reducing the risk means opposite. If you think, you will have 70% chance if you do meditation and yoga. That means 0.40 is there, that is a normal chance, and that 0.40 will be reduced by 70% if you do meditation and yoga. Means 0.40 into 0.70. Means normal person who is doing nothing, getting heart attack is 0.4, for example. And if you do meditation and yoga, if that person is doing meditation and yoga, again his chance will reduce. Again his chance will reduce, in the sense you will get a probability who is less than 0.4. That is what here it is. 0.28 is the answer. Means 0.40, a normal person who is getting heart attack, into, if you do meditation and yoga, if he is doing meditation and yoga, his chance is again 70% only. 30% his chance is reduced. Means getting heart attack chance is only 70%. So 0.40 into 0.70, that is 0.28. Normal way, if you think, a normal person who is having a heart attack, who is getting heart attack chance is 0.4. And if you do meditation and yoga, his chance is 0.28. The chance is reducing, 0.28. Next is P of A given E2. P of A given E2 in the sense, a person who is suffering from heart attack even after he is doing some kind of drugs prescriptions. So that is 0.40 is a normal one, into taking medicine reduces the risk by 25%. Means 75% chance is there for getting heart attack. So 0.40 into 0.75, that is equal to 0.30. Here also you can check. Previously it was 0.4 was the probability. After taking drugs, his chance is reduced to 0.30. So 0.40 into 0.75, 0.30. So these two steps you have to be very careful when you do the calculation. Next we can go for probability that the patient suffering from heart attack followed a course of meditation and yoga is given by P of E1 given A. So a person who is doing yoga and meditation, given that he is suffering from heart attack. So you have taken a person from the group, he is suffering from heart attack, and we have to find out the probability that the person is from E1 group. E1 group in the sense he is doing meditation and yoga. That is P of E1 given A is equal to Bayes theorem, P of E1 into P of A given E1 divided by some. That is P of E1 into P of A given E1 plus P of E2 into P of A given E2. Let's substitute the values. P of E1, that we know, that is 1 by 2, into P of A given E1, we have calculated 0.28. Again here these two same in the numerator, 1 by 2 into 0.28 plus P of E2. P of E2 is again 1 by 2 into A given E2. A given E2 is 0.30. So here little bit of calculation part is there, that you will try it as homework. Number 14. If each element of a second order determinant is either 0 or 1, what is the probability that the value of the determinant is positive? Assume that the individual entries of the determinant are chosen independently, each value being assumed with the probability 1 by 2. Here, each element of a second order determinant is either 0 or 1. By using these two numbers, we are forming a determinant, second order determinant, means 2 by 2 determinant. First of all, let's find out how many ways we can form this determinant by using these two numbers. So here numbers which we are using is 2, 0 and 1. Two numbers we are using, order is 2 by 2. So the total possible ways is 2 power 4. This 2 is 0 and 1. There are two numbers we are using. And this 4 how comes in the sense, the product of the order, 2 by 2, means 2 into 2 is 4. So 2 power 4 is 16 ways. And here the question is the probability that the value of the determinant is positive. The value of the determinant is positive in these cases only. Here when you check 1001, and here the first diagonal should be fixed, because this is the way we subtract, first diagonal minus the second diagonal. The first diagonal should be bigger, then only you will get the positive value. So 1 into 1 minus 0 into 0, that is 1. Here again this diagonal is fixed and here 0 and 1. Here 1 we put and here 0 we put. So 1 minus 0 again positive. And again this diagonal we fixed and only these two numbers we have interchanged. So 1 minus 0 again that is positive. So these are the only three possible ways we are getting the positive values of the determinant. Here other cases are here like this. Just we didn't fix the diagonal and the other possible way. This is not that much necessary here. Just I'm showing here, that's all. Whenever you do, that is not a positive values are coming. Here you can see 1 into 0, 0, 0 minus 0, that is 0. Here also same thing. Here when you multiply, you are not getting the positive values. So your favorable outcome is only 3. Total outcome is 16. So here the possible ways we have written from here, and required probability is 3 divided by 16. Only in 3 cases we are getting the positive values. Total number of ways 16. So 3 divided by 16 is the required probability. Next we shall discuss question number 15. An electronic assembly consists of two subsystems, say A and B. From previous testing procedures, the following probabilities are assumed to be known. P of A fails is equal to 0.2, P of B fails alone 0.15, P of A and B fails 0.15. Evaluate the following probabilities. P of A fails given that B has failed. Second one, P of A fails alone. Some probabilities are mentioned here. We are asked to calculate these two. First of all, let's draw a Venn diagram. There is a universal set U, two subsets A and B, and the blue shaded portion, it shows B alone or B fails alone. Here B fails alone can be calculated from the entire B circle. We have to subtract the intersection portion, means probability of B fails, the entire circle means B fails, minus A and B failed, that means A intersection B. So P of B fails alone, it is given to us, B fails alone is 0.15, equal to P of B fails minus A and B fail. A and B fails is given to us 0.15. From here, just to take this 0.15 to the left side, 0.15 plus 0.15 is equal to probability of B fails. So probability of B fails is equal to, when we add these two, we will get 0.30. Then first part we are going to solve, probability of A fails given that B has failed, that is equal to B A fails given that B has failed. That means here probability of A and B failed divided by probability of B failed, means the probability of A given B, in the sense we know the formula P of A intersection B divided by P of B. A intersection B, in the sense A and B both failed, divided by denominator P of B, that is P of B failed. So P of A and B fail, that we have calculated, that it is given to us A and B fail, that is 0.15, divided by probability of B fail, it is 0.30. When we calculate, we will get 1/2. Just multiply 100 numerator and denominator, or do it, or else directly we can cancel. Next one, 0.15 we will get when you divide 192. Question number 2. P of A fails alone, that is what the second part we have to do. P of A fails alone means this is the portion, just opposite of here, this one, okay. A fails alone means this shaded portion, that is P of A fails minus P of A and B fail, the intersection portion, that is 0.20. P of A fails, it is given to us 0.20, minus A and B fail, A and B fail is 0.15. When you subtract, you will get 0.05. So probability of A fails alone is 0.05. Next we shall discuss question number 16. Bag 1 contains 3 red and 4 black balls, and bag 2 contains 4 red and 5 black balls. One ball is transferred from bag 1 to bag 2, and then a ball is drawn from bag 2. The ball drawn is found to be red in color. Find the probability that the transferred ball is black. So let's go through the question again. Bag 1 contains 3 red and 4 black balls, and bag 2 contains 4 red and 5 black balls. One ball is transferred from bag 1 to bag 2. One ball you have taken from bag 1 and just put it into bag 2. And then a ball is drawn from bag 2. The ball so drawn is found to be red in color. Find the property that the transferred ball is black. That is what the question. So let's assume E1 and E2 denote the event that a red ball is transferred from bag 1 to bag 2 and a black ball is transferred from bag 1 to bag 2. So here one ball is transferred from bag 1 to bag 2. That is what the question. Means there are two chances. One ball means there is a red ball chance is there and a black ball also chance is there. So it will be E1 and E2. E1 means you are transferring a red ball and E2 means you are transferring a black ball. P of E1 in the sense the probability of transferring or taking a red ball. In the sense here we have 3 red balls are there out of 7 total balls. So 3 by 7 is the probability. And P of E2 in the sense you are transferring a black ball in the sense there are only 4 black balls out of 7. So 4 divided by 7 is the probability of choosing a black ball and transferring it from bag 1 to bag 2. Let A be the event that the ball drawn is red. Here, when a red ball is transferred from bag 1 to bag 2, P of A given E1 is equal to P of A given E1 in the sense A means you are choosing a red ball given that E1 means you have transferred a red ball from bag 1 to bag 2. That is 5 divided by 10. 5 divided by 10 in the sense you have already transferred one red ball to bag 2. One red ball to bag 2 in the sense bag 2 is having 4 red. So one red ball coming from bag 1 to bag 2. That means it becomes 5 red balls. And the total 5 plus 4, 9 balls were there. And one ball coming from bag 1. So 9 plus 1, 10 balls. So the probability is 5 by 10. That is equal to 1 by 2. Hope it is clear. Probability of A given E1 in the sense A in the sense the ball drawn is red. You are choosing a red ball. Given that you have transferred a red ball from bag 1 to bag 2. While transferring a red ball from bag 1 to bag 2, bag 2 is having 4 red balls, one coming from bag 1. That means here there is 5 red balls now. Total 5 plus 4, 9 plus 1 ball coming from bag 1. So total 10. So 5 divided by 10 is the probability. That is equal to 1 by 2. When a black ball is transferred from bag 1 to bag 2, P of A given E2 in the sense A, choosing a red ball. Given that a black ball is transferred from bag 1. Choosing a red ball, given that a black ball is transferred from bag 1. Here choosing a red ball in the sense there is only 4 red balls. Because one ball coming from bag 1 is a black ball. So black ball means here black ball number will increase to 6. 6 plus 4, 10. Total 10 balls. Red ball remains the same. So 4 divided by 10. When you cancel 2, it will come as 2 by 5. Probability of E2 given A. So you are E2 in the sense you are transferring a black ball from bag 1 to bag 2. That is E2. E2 it is already defined here. E2 is transferring a black ball from bag 1 to bag 2. Given that you have taken a red ball. Let A be the event that the ball drawn is red. So given that the ball taken is red. Probability formula by using Bayes theorem, P of E2 into P of A given E2 divided by the sum of the probabilities. That is equal to P of E2 we have calculated 4 by 7 into A given E2. A given E2 it is here 2 by 5. Plus P of E1 into P of A given E1. E1 in the sense 3 by 7 into A given E1 is 1 by 2. Plus then 4 by 7 into 2 by 5. That is equal to, when you do the calculation, you will get it as 16 divided by 31. This is only the answer. There are steps we have to write for calculation. So that steps you have to write and make sure that you are getting the answer as 16 by 31. Next, we shall discuss question number 17. The question is, if A and B are two events such that P of A not equal to 0 and P of B given A is equal to 1, then there are four options given to us. A is a subset of B, B is a subset of A, B is equal to null set and A is equal to null set. Out of these four options, we have to choose the most appropriate answer. A and B are two events. P of A not equal to 0 and P of B given A is 1. This is the condition given to us. P of B given A is equal to 1. P of B given a formula, we know P of A intersection B divided by P of A equal to 1. When you cross multiply, P of A intersection B is equal to P of A will come. Then here P of A intersection B is equal to P of A. This is quite familiar for us. Previously also we have done. A and B common portion is A. Means diagrammatically it will come like this. A and B common portion is A. P of A. P of A intersection B is P of A. Means A and B common portion is A. Means here we can conclude that A is a subset of B. So the option A is the correct one. Let's mark option A. Move on to question number 18. If P of A given B is greater than P of A, then which of the following is correct? Four options. P of B given A less than P of B, P of A intersection B less than P of A into P of B, P of B given A greater than P of B given A equal to P of B. Here, given P of A given B is greater than P of A. P of A given B greater than P of A in the sense, let's write the formula for P of A given B. P of A intersection B by P of B greater than P of A. So P of A intersection B is equal to, this will come here, P of A into P of B. Then P of A intersection B, take back this P of A to the denominator. That is P of A intersection B by P of A is greater than P of B. Just a rearrangement, taking P of A to the denominator. That is P of A intersection B by P of A. We know that it is P of B given A is greater than P of B. So option C is the correct one. P of B given A is greater than P of B. So let's mark it. Move on to the last question of this exercise. If A and B are any two events such that P of A plus P of B minus P of A and B is equal to P of A, then there are four options given to us. P of B given A is equal to 1, P of A given B is equal to 1, P of B given A is equal to 0, P of A given B is equal to 0. You have to choose the most appropriate option. Here, given condition is P of A plus P of B minus P of A and B is equal to P of A. So let's rewrite this statement. That is P of A plus P of B minus P of A and B, we can write it as P of A intersection B equal to P of A. Here on the right side and left side there is P of A common, we can cancel it. Then we will get as P of B minus P of A intersection B is equal to 0. That is P of B is equal to, let's take this A intersection B to the right side, minus becomes plus. So P of B is equal to P of A intersection B. That is dividing by P of B in the sense, we will get left side as 1 equal to P of A intersection B by P of B. That is P of A intersection by P of B, we know the formula, that is P of A given B. So we can write it as P of A given B is 1. So B is the correct answer. So let's mark option B. Dear students, today we have discussed question number 12 to 19 from the miscellaneous exercise of chapter 13, probability. I request all the students to go through the entire miscellaneous exercise, and if you have any doubt, please note it and keep. We will discuss it during the discussion session. Thank you for watching.